Yo guys, Jonathan here with an unboxing of the brand new 2018 13-inch MacBook Pro. For the first time ever,
we did it again.
We have a quad-core 13-inch MacBook Pro. I am excited. Let's go. So here we go, and I realized I don't have a knife, so I think I'm gonna have to try and use this bottle cap. Probably not the best idea, but... There we go, got it. So like I said, I am super excited for this 13-inch MacBook Pro. I'm really excited for the 6-core 15-inch MacBook Pro, but again, I've wanted a quad-core 13-inch MacBook Pro for the longest time. Something about the form factor of the 13-inch MacBook Pro just kind of calls my name. The 15-inch MacBook Pro does get a little heavy. It's a little cumbersome to bring around. So I'm going to responsibly go throw this away in the trash. There will be no littering today on this unboxing. So if you're watching this video curious what happened to the 13-inch MacBook Pro without Touch Bar, that actually didn't get updated. And if it's confusing, go ahead and check the video out here or down below and that will explain everything. Only the Touch Bar 13 and 15-inch MacBook Pro were updated, and here we are. Now, of course, I went with space gray because that is the only way you go. Space gray or get out, Austin. Pulling this MacBook Pro out of the box. That satisfying plastic. Set that off to the side for 1 second. I'm gonna toss it to the side for a second. I swear I'm gonna throw it away. Again, if you guys have seen a MacBook Pro unboxing, you've probably seen this before. We get the literature inside, MacBook Pro, and most importantly, Apple stickers. Aside from that, we have the USB-C cable and the USB-C power brick that is tiny, just like the 13-inch MacBook Pro. Again, this is the baseline Touch Bar 13-inch MacBook Pro, so it is the cheapest way to get into a quad-core 13-inch MacBook Pro. This, of course, is maxed out up to 2 terabytes with 16 gigabytes of RAM, but this particular model comes with 256 gigabytes of flash storage and 8 gigabytes of RAM. That's one of the coolest things about picking up a MacBook Pro, is trash sliding between my feet. But if you pick up a MacBook Pro, the minute you open the lid, it starts booting up, which is kind of a cool experience. It is talking to me. Setting this up, we're going to select English because aside from some poor Spanish, that is the only language I know. Curious though, if you speak multiple languages, let me know how many with a comment down below. Someone's Wi-Fi is named Country Mouse. Red Robster. Red Robster. Now, I will be testing this baseline 13-inch MacBook Pro against the fastest, highest-end spec 13-inch MacBook Pro you can buy, as well as the 6-core 15-inch MacBook Pro. But in terms of early impressions, the quad-core CPU makes a huge difference. As far as Geekbench goes, last year's baseline model got a single-core score of 4,113 and a multi-core score of 8,875. Jumping over to this year's model, single-core is not a huge difference at 4,702, but where we see the massive difference is in the multi-core score with those two extra cores with a score of 16,916, which is crazy. So I've been wanting that kind of power in a 13-inch MacBook Pro forever. To finally see it is awesome. I will definitely be putting this thing through its paces in terms of video editing, graphics performance, Photoshop, Lightroom, you name it. If you guys want to see anything in the follow-up video, definitely drop me a line or suggestion down below. Aside from that, that's kind of my first look at this brand new 13-inch MacBook Pro. Super excited to stack it against all the other models and let you know what the best bang for your buck is. Definitely subscribe if you haven't yet so you don't miss that. This is Jonathan, and I will catch you guys later.